Dear students, once again, I, Mr. Vishal Shaha, welcome you all to this another session of the chapter UV visible spectroscopy. Now, in previous video, we have discussed about the Woodward-Fisher rule that is applied for the dyes. We have seen in detail how different values for the lambda max are calculated. Also, we have seen one example how to calculate the lambda max for given molecular structure. In this video, we are going to see few another examples belonging to the class dienes, polyenes, as well as the trienes, where we are going to see how to calculate the lambda max depending upon the molecular structure by using Woodward-Fisher rule. So let's begin with today's session. Before this, just we will see what are the learning outcomes of this session. After this session, students will be able to calculate the lambda max for the dienes, trienes and polyene from their molecular structure. Now, we are familiar with this particular chart. Now, we know that these dienes are mainly the, if it is a cyclic diene, then it will be a homoannular diene or it may be a heteroannular diene. Acyclic conjugated diene and heteroannular dienes, they are having the same value, that is the 215 nanometer. If the homoannular diene is there, then it is a 253 nanometer. If acyclic diene is there, then it will be having a parent value of 245 nanometer. Also, we have seen how we are going to use these increments as well as the how different oxochromes, if they are present, the values that are to be added. So, I hope that you have noted these particular values. If not, you can note down these particular values because this will be required for calculating the lambda max for a given structure. Now, today we are going to discuss some other examples apart from the example that we have seen in last video. Now, you have to calculate the lambda max for the given compound. Now, this is your given compound. Now, in previous case, we have seen the calculation of lambda max for the homoannular diene. Now, if you see this particular structure, first we have to check which parent compound is this, whether it is a homoannular diene, whether it is a heteroannular diene, or whether it is a acyclic. So, by observing this figure, we can easily say that this particular diene means it starts from this carbon atom, this carbon atom, this carbon atom, and this carbon atom. That's why this mark is given over here. So, this structure is nothing but your diene. Now, as these two double bonds are present in two different rings, this is the example of heteroannular diene. And if you see, this carbon atom is having this substitution, this carbon atom is having this substitution. These are known as ring residues. Means these two carbon atoms are having two ring residues, and similarly, these two carbon atoms are having these two ring residues. So, means in total, this ring is having four different ring residues. So, as we have said, that parent value for heteroannular diene is 215 nanometer. In addition to that, we have to use increments, that is the four ring residues are there. Out of that, first one is this, second one is this, third one is this, and fourth one is this. Means we have to check the whatever the carbon atoms that are involved in the diene structure, they are connected to which part. And if we make the total of this, we will get the 235 nanometer. So, this is the calculated value by using the Woodward-Fisher rule. And the observed value for this compound is 236. So, remember that when this rule was proposed, there were no any instrument is there to calculate the lambda max. So, you can imagine how applying the theory, how the Woodward-Fisher, they have determined this particular rule, which are giving approximate or the correct values by using the instrument also. So this is about the first example. Then second example that we are going to discuss, calculate the lambda max for the given compound. Now this is your given compound. Now just I request you pause this video and try to solve this particular question. Calculate the lambda max for given this particular compound. Once you have finished, then again play this video. Now first you have to mark the which part of this structure is consisting of diene part. So here I have marked this particular part where you can see this is your diene, which is consisting of involvement of this carbon atom, this carbon atom, this carbon atom, and this carbon atom. Now first thing you have to identify whether it is a homoannular diene or heteroannular diene. By observing figure you can easily understand it is a heteroannular diene because both the double bonds are present in the different ring. So parent value for heteroannular diene is 215 nanometer. Now you have to calculate the ring residues. Now this carbon atom is having this one ring residue. As this carbon atom is common to both the rings, this carbon atom is having another ring residue. Further, this carbon atom does not have any ring residue and this carbon atom is having this ring residue. So total 3 ring residues are present on this particular diene. So for 3 ring residues, the value is 5 × 3, that is the 15. And in addition to that, here there is a presence of one exocyclic double bond is present. Exocyclic double bond means what? As this carbon atom is a part of this ring and also it is involved in the formation of this double bond. So this double bond is considered as an exocyclic double bond to this ring, and that's why for that we have to carry out the addition of 5 as a increment. So total calculated value becomes 235 nanometer, and the observed value is also 235 nanometer. Means accurate values are obtained by calculating the lambda max by using the Woodward-Fisher rule. Means in this way we have to check whether the alkyl substituents are there, whether ring residues are there, whether exocyclic double bond is there, or whether endocyclic double bonds that are present in the given ring. Then we will see next example. Now we have to calculate the lambda max for this particular compound. Again same, you can pause this video, calculate the lambda max and try to solve this particular example. Once you have finished, then you can play this video. Now as usual, first we have to identify which type of diene is there. Now here you can see these are the double bonds, means this particular part is nothing but your diene. As these two double bonds are present in the side chain, this is not a cyclic diene, means it must be a acyclic diene. So for parent value for parent acyclic diene is 215 nanometer, which is same as of the heteroannular diene. Further, here there is a presence of two alkyl substitutions. How? See, here this particular diene does not have this particular substitution. In addition to that, this particular carbon atom is having this alkyl substitution. Further, now this carbon atom, which is a part of the diene, it is having these two ring residues. For that we have to calculate 2 × 5, that is equal to 10. And as this particular double bond is exocyclic to this ring, as this carbon atom is involved in the formation of double bond, also this carbon atom, as it is a part of this ring, so this ring, this double bond is exocyclic to this particular ring, which adds an increment of the 5. So these are the total increments that we have to calculate. How alkyl substitutions are calculated? This carbon atom is having this alkyl substitution, this carbon atom is having this alkyl substitution, means two alkyl substitutions are there in addition to that these two ring residues. So togetherly, if we make a total, it becomes 240 nanometer. And observed value for this compound is also same, that is the 240 nanometer. In this way, we can use the Woodward-Fisher rule to calculate the lambda max for given different substances. Further, next, another example that we will see, calculate the lambda max for the given compound. The example is this structure. Now, first you have to identify what type of it dyne is. It is a heteroannular dyne. Now, how it is heteroannular dyne? Because you can see these are the two double bonds. Out of that, one double bond is present within the ring and second double bond is present outside the ring. Though it is a not a part of the other ring, if it is present outside, then also it is calculated as a heteroannular dyne. And for that purpose, parent value becomes 215 nanometer. Further, here you can see there is presence of, so first we have to mark this particular dyne. You can mark like this. So this is your dyne. So this carbon atom is having this ring residue. This carbon atom is having this ring residue. So total two ring residues are present on this particular carbon atom. Togetherly for that, 10 nanometers we have to add as an increment. Further that, it can be easily understood that this double bond is exocyclic to this particular ring, because it is not a part of the ring, but one of the carbon atom is involved in the that particular formation of double bond. And so if we make the total, it becomes 230 nanometer. And the calculated value and observed value are same for this particular structure also. In this way, we can use different examples and we can use different molecular structures to calculate the lambda max for using the Woodward-Fisher rule. Further, last example that we are going to see in this video is this particular structure. Now, as you go on, the whatever the increments are there, you have to find out the each increment, because if we miss the one of the increment, then definitely that particular value will be wrong. Such a different types of the questions are generally asked in your GPAT examination. Definitely one example will be there that we have to calculate the Woodward-Fisher rule for given structure. So you have to practice for more structures. Now here, this particular compound is having a homoannular dyne. Now here you can see, if we consider this particular part as a dyne, it is a heteroannular dyne. And if we consider this particular part, it is a homoannular dyne. Whenever such a situation is there, if we get homo as well as the heteroannular dyne in a given structure, we have to go for the homoannular dyne first. Okay, so our dyne is having this particular structure. Further, in addition to that, it will be having now four ring residues. One is this, second one is this, third one is this, and fourth one is this. So it will be having four different ring residues. So for that, we can make calculate the 20 as a increment. In addition to that, this particular structure is having two exocyclic double bonds. Now how? You can see this particular double bond is exocyclic to this ring, because the carbon atom of this ring is involved in this particular double bond, and this double bond is exocyclic to this ring. So due to which we have to carry out the addition of the 5 as increment for one exocyclic double bond. This double bond is not exocyclic. This double bond is extending the conjugation. Extending the conjugation means what? Here, after this particular dyne, there is a single bond and again double bond is there. For that, we have to carry out the addition of the 13 nanometer. So if you make a total, it becomes 313 nanometer. Now suppose if another double bond is present, again it extends the conjugation. So again, you have to carry out the addition of the another 13 nanometer. In this way, we have to calculate the values. So total becomes 313 and observed value is also 315. In this way, by using Woodward-Fisher rule, we can calculate the different values for the given molecular structure. Thank you. If you like the video, please share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.